Now, as you understand the theoretical concepts, let me show you the real world products. So as you can see here, the screen in front of you, it's an actual firewall which is deployed in a customer scenario. This is how generally it will look like. As you can see here, these are the various offices and the equipments those organizations use to protect that particular branch, right? So this is how generally will look like. Right now I'm showing you a screen of Check Point being a world leader in terms of providing the security. Other vendors are like Palo Alto, Cisco, FortiGate. They also have similar kind of products. So now let's talk about how exactly they work in order to provide you a security. So as you can see here, Check Point products looks like this, and a box will have these kind of features. Primarily, as you can see here, firewall is inbuilt, so you have to have some policies which is required in order to protect your internal network, right? You want to apply the access list. Now you have an IPsec VPN so that you can create a tunnel between two offices, or you can give access to your remote employees so that they can connect to your office and securely access the content. Now mobile access is mentioned here, so basically it is nothing but an SSL VPN. So Check Point uses the term called mobile access. As you can see here, like various vendors will use a different name, but the concepts remain the same. Application control feature basically tries to control the applications. Applications are something like Google Talk, chat. So these are the things which can be considered as application. They are not website. These are the application which is used to achieve certain kind of objectives. Similarly, you have URL filtering. So these are the controls provided by security vendors in order to control what kind of websites internal employees can access. For example, you may want to give access to YouTube for your marketing team, but you want to restrict YouTube access or Facebook access to the interns or the people who have just recently joined your organization, because you want them to focus on their the initial training. And maybe as a good organization, you may prefer to give them internet access or browsing during the lunchtime. So those kind of restrictions you can apply. Identity awareness is another technical term used by Check Point. Other vendors may be using a different name. Ideally, what it happens is it tries to integrate your security device to your Active Directory server so that they can get the name rather than having an IP address. Those concepts are a little complicated if you're just a beginner, but if you are an intermediate level, you will understand this feature basically allows you to create rules based on the name of the users who are there in the AD rather than having an IP address. So this is how, as you can see here, there are many other features like content awareness, QoS and all. But the one which I have explained to you in the previous videos, I will keep it to simple, and we'll focus on those features at this point of time because they are the most common, and almost every organization you will see, you will notice that they are using this feature. So IPS is there, deep packet inspection. So we have already discussed the Check Point is having an IPS feature as well, anti-bot, antivirus. So these are another solutions which are provided, and every feature of this has some kind of activity, some kind of protection which is being provided to you. So let's do one thing. Let's go back to our policy package and then see how does it look like. So as I have explained in the first video, in the common security control devices, you have something called firewall. So how does a firewall will look like? So this is a commercial tool. People pay a lot of money to buy this tool and acquire certain skills and manage it on day to day. Almost all large organization will have product from Check Point, like almost like Fortune 500 companies definitely use this product. Okay, so as you can see here, it allows you to type some name here and then a source represented by admin. Let's click what is inside the admin. As you can see here, some users are defined, that's coming from the AD most probably, or it could be a group. So you're telling that admin of an organization will have access to your gateway. So gateway being a destination and source being an admin. And if they are trying to access certain services, like basically a port, like they can do HTTPS, they can do SSH, and they can also access remotely port 8200, which is allowed. And then only these services will be allowed and the action is accept. And when this accept is happening, you also want to create a log for those kind of access, right? So this is a typical rules. As you can go here, like Okay, the next rule says anybody else trying to access corporate gateway for any service whatsoever, they should be dropped. So ideally what it means, the combination of these two rules says only admins are allowed to access the corporate gateways. Okay, so that is how it is. Only admins are allowed to access the gateways on certain port. That's it. Everybody else is blocked. So that way you are safeguarding the security components itself. So people cannot access the firewall itself and hack it, right? Then you have LAN, everybody else, they have a VPN column, then you add accept, right? You allow the LAN people to access the branch office. So between these two, you want to allow everything. So that is how the service column is any. So what I'm trying to demonstrate is this is the rule which is there in a typical firewall policies. And whenever the packet is received by a firewall, start from top and go to second, third, fourth, fifth. And then as long as it matches the packet, it will do this action. Okay. So the moment it met somebody, suppose a hacker or a marketing guy or a sales people trying to access firewall. So source will be any, so their IP address will be matched and destination is gateway. Like they want to try to access security device. Since they are not from the admin side, it will be blocked. Right. So this is how a typical firewall will look like. Almost all organizations, mid-size or large size, will have this product for sure. Maybe from a different vendor, but this is how a firewall rule base is created. So you need to acquire this skill. So we have a checkpoint course also on our virtual academy. If you are interested in learning and acquiring that skills, you will be able to have that as well. Thank you.